It wasn't a date, but we both knew it was a date. Before that, though, I had to make the most of my new pointless shitty manual job.
Hello? Will McKenzie? I'm here for work experience.
Hello, you must be Will. Great to meet you, I'm Jim. This is Wolfie and Steve.
Hi, Jim. Hi, Steve.
Hello, Wolf.
Wolfie.
Wolfie, right, gotcha.
You'll have a right old laugh here, long as you don't mind a bit of the blue talk. Not a puff, are you?
No.
Not a problem if you are, just be a bit harder to join in some of the banter. So, was there any part of car mechanics you were specially interested in, as it goes?
To be honest, none of it, as it goes.
More interested in bikes, is it?
No, the media. Or law. Right. Look, no offence, but I'm never going to work in a place like this.
Place like this?
You know, a place like this. Manual. Dirty. Not stupid, exactly, but not academic by a long chalk. It's not that I'm better than this, it's just that I'm much cleverer than you need to be to work here.
Stevie's got a BTEC.
Exactly. Look, I suspect the mix-up will be sorted today. I'll be gone by tomorrow.
I see. You don't mind opening that today, then?
No, of course not. Just the once, eh?
Right then, Chomley Warner. First job is we need some stuff picking up from the suppliers.
Fine. Let me just get a pen and paper. Great.
OK, we need 2 tins of tartan paint.
Tartan paint times 2?
Spirit level bubbles.
Bubbles for spirit level.
You need anything, Wolfie?
Yeah. Ask them for a reach around.
Oh, reach around.
Don't forget, you really need that.
Fine. So that's 2 tins of tartan paint, bubbles for spirit level, and oh, reach around.
And you might as well ask for a long wait while you're there.
Great. This is a joke, isn't it?
What?
These items. They're not real things, are they? They don't exist.
I don't know what you mean.
Now, I know that these initiation ceremonies exist in certain types of workplace, and don't get me wrong, I enjoy the camaraderie, but you have to get up pretty early to fool me.
No, fair enough, you caught us out.
Yeah, fair cop.
Too sharp for us. I'll tell you what, why don't we initiate you with a pint at lunch instead?
Great.
We'll go to the Crown. Barmaid in there's got a smashing pair of tits.
Okay.
So while I was getting the City and Guilds in tits, Neil was at the newspaper, happily wasting the opportunity of my lifetime.
Toby, your work experience is here.
Oh, fine. All right. Hi, you must be Neil. Toby.
All right.
So, tell me, what are you looking to get out of this assignment, Neil?
Oh, don't worry, I won't steal nothing.
No. What I meant was, is there anything specifically you'd like to do while you're with us or an area of journalism you're particularly interested in?
No, not really.
Right. And do you have any questions you'd like to ask me about anything?
How long's my lunch hour?
An hour.
Meanwhile, Jay really had arranged some great work experience for Simon, freezing his arse off at a disgusting plant hire yard.
This is shit. I don't want to do this for a living.
That's all right. We'll be able to drive the diggers soon, I reckon.
Oi, Jay. What are you stopped for?
This is meant to be work experience, not standing around being a useless twat experience. You don't need any experience of that. You're the expert.
Sorry, Dad. We only stopped for a moment. This is well knackering.
Well, you better get used to it. Because with your brains, you'll be fucking lucky to get a job throwing shit into a skip.
This isn't exactly how you described it, Jay.
Getting many Valentine's cards this year then, Simon?
Just the one.
It's one more than Jay's ever got.
I've got plenty.
Don't worry, son. There's a girl out there for you somewhere. You just need to find a desperate bird that likes the smell of BO and blokes with tiny cocks. Now get back to work. I ain't paying you to sit on your scrawny arse all day.
Nice.
All right. What are you doing here? I thought you meant to be over at the newspaper.
I have been. They let me go home at lunch.
You jammy bastard.
Oi, Si, what's all this I hear about you having a fight with Danny Moore?
What? Who's Danny Moore?
He's been mouthing off about how he's going to do you in.
Who is he? I don't even know who he is.
That kid you bumped into and then called a short ass.
That was Jay.
Oh, well, you'll have to go and knock him out now, Si. Teach him a lesson.
Neil, if you see him, just tell him he's made a mistake.
I'm not getting involved. I heard he's from a well-hard family in Northwood. His brother did time.
Oh, Northwood? Bit nice knowing you, Si.
Oh, what is this? My dad's bigger than your dad. What are we, 12?
I think he is 12, actually.
You're not scared, are you, Si?
No, it's just I'm not going to look cool beating up a kid.
And you couldn't?
Yeah, I fucking could. Now, can we just leave it? I'm not fighting anyone. Oh, yeah, nice one. Mature.
Compared to Simon, my first day was turning out OK. After a morning of pretending cars were broken and overcharging middle-class women, we had bonded over a pint.
Thanks for that, guys. That was a much more civilised way to welcome me. It's a shame we were going to do it again, but I'd... Oh, no! Hey! Oh, no! A kidnap? Why? You're cutting me out,
Paida! Don't shit yourself. We're just going for a little drive.
Hello, mate.
Come on, guys. Is this really necessary? What about my allergies?
Come on, let's talk about this.
Please! My allergies!
Was you expecting that, was you, mastermind? See you tomorrow.
Institutionalised bullying wasn't quite the work experience I had in mind, but I knew how to deal with bullies. I got my mum to tell the teacher.